Hello everyone, welcome back to our online classes after summer vacation. So today I am going to explain the chapter number 6, that is digging for treasure. And the digging means remove earth sand, and the meaning of treasure is a quantity of precious metals, gems or other valuable objects. And this is very interesting story about a family with 6 children. And this story is written by Edith Nepsit. Before dealing the chapter, I'm going to tell about Edith Nepsit. Okay, so see this picture. This picture is related to Edith Nepsit. And she was an English author and poet who published her books for children under the name of E. Nepsit. She wrote or collaborated on more than 60 books of fiction for children. And here is the meaning of fiction is something that is not real, something that is out of imagination. The story of Treasure Seeker, published in 1899. Is told from a child's point of view. This is an adapted version from the original story. Its sequels are the Would-Be Goats and the New Treasure Seekers. The complete name of the book is The Story of the Treasure Seekers, being the adventures of the vegetable children in search of fortune. Here is the fortune, meaning is luck, destiny. It is the story of 6 siblings. The first one is Dora, the eldest, Oswald, Dickie, Alice and Noel, the twins, Noel and Horace Octavius, the youngest, also known as H.O. and their attempts to assist their widowed father and recover the fortunes of their family. They stayed in London during the Victorian time. The narration is by one of the children who does not reveal his or her identity till the end. The children belong to the Honorable House of Bastable. Treasure hunt is an organized game in which the players have to find the hidden object or treasure through a series of clues. It could be played as an individual or team game. The treasure could be anything depending on where it is being played. There are many variations of the game, and some are known by different names, such as letterboxing, armchair treasure hunt, and guillotine, etc. Now, I'm going to explain the summary of this chapter firstly. Okay, now listen carefully and you have to write this summary in your rough notebook. This is your classwork. The extract begins with a description of the tools that the children bring out into the garden to hunt for the hidden treasure. It goes on to describe the area they had marked out for digging and how they could not find anything but worms and stones. However, they do not lose hope and decide to explore anything part of the ground. They manage to get the help of their neighbor, Albert, by promising a part of their treasure. They also convinced him to go down into the pit and help make a tunnel. In the bargain, Albert got stuck as the roof of the tunnel came down. The children then ran for help to Albert's uncle, who managed to get his nephew out. The children could not find any treasure. Albert's uncle found two half crowns on the ground. The children were honest and hopeful in the end. So this is the summary, and you have to write this one in your rough notebook. Now let's start reading. Okay, come to the page number 36. So from here, The Treasure Seekers is a story about a family of six children. Their mother is not alive and their father's business has failed. So here the father cannot afford to send the children to school. He cannot buy good food to feed them. So as the business failed, they are not able to go to school. Hence, the children decide to solve the family's problem themselves. And the nursery, they gather and plan to find treasure to restore their family's fallen fortunes. So here, it is enough of the pain which they are going through. They are facing difficulties day by day. They have not any privilege as compared to the other children. So they decide to fight. They decided to find the solution of the problems. Each suggests a different idea and they try them out one by one. So, six siblings, different ideas, different points of views. So, it takes time to get the plan, the confirmed plan. So, this is how the story just began. And let's see what they plan and what they decide to find their solution of the problems. Now, from the first paragraph, we got spades from the cellar to dig for treasure and marked out a square in the garden and began to dig. So among of the six siblings, one is narrating this story. They all gathered in the garden and brought spades and marked a square in the garden and they started to dig. But we found only worms and stones. So we thought we had tried another part of the garden where the ground was softer. We dug and found nothing. So here they began to dig, found nothing. They found only worms and stones. So they decided to change the place and started to dig in new place, which is much softer compared to the previous place where they have dug. Presently, Albert from next door looked over the wall and said, "Hello." "Hello, what are you up to?" So one of the boy of neighborhood want to know that children were in the garden and making noise. So he just wondering what is happening there. So one of the child replied that, "We are digging for treasure," said Alice. "An ancient parchment revealed to us the place of concealment. Come over and help us. When we dig deep enough, we will find a great pot of red clay full of gold and precious jewels." So in this paragraph, they finally, one of the character that is among of the six siblings, one is Alice, she said that, "We are digging for treasure and parchment. It is sure that it's proved that if they dig enough, and what happened? They find a pot of a red clay full of gold and precious jewels." Here is the meaning of concealment. Concealment means place of hiding. And parchment. Parchment means, here is written, paper or material containing a document. Albert, who has no imagination, sniggered and said, "Nonsense." So here Albert did not believe them because it is not possible. So he sniggered. Sniggered means to laugh at something, at someone. Here is also written the meaning of sniggered, laughed in an unpleasant way. So here Albert is not believing that it is possible to find out anything from the ground. So he laughed and said it is nonsense. Oswald, one of the character among the six siblings, Oswald promised him a share of the treasure if he dug, and Alice said she would lend him her spade. So Albert came over the wall and dug. All of us dug and dug. Soon the hole got deep. So finally Albert agreed, and Alice handed over the spade to him, and he started digging. And very soon the hole got deep. We all have to dig a tunnel to get to the treasure, said Oswald. Jumping in and digging at one side, we all took turns to dig, except Albert, who was afraid to go in. So one of the smartest among of them, that is Oswald, said, if we digging a tunnel, why we don't get in and digging one of the side? Let us make a tunnel. Through the tunnel, we reach to the treasure. Everybody agreed, and they turned decide to dig, and it was turned to other. But Albert did not reveal to take. So, come on, Albert, said Alice. It's quite easy. You just crawl in and dig with your hands. You won't notice that it's a dark in the tunnel if you keep your eyes shut tight. So children were in tunnel, they closing their eyes and crawling. Alice gave them idea how to dig. But Albert refused to go in and dig with his hands as we had done. Let me go in feet first, he said. I will dig with my boots, honor bright. So he did not want to go in first in that way, and he replied, and he said, let me go in first. Because of due to the darkness, he does not want to take risk and to take and dig with boats. So we let him go in feet first with only his head sticking out of the hole. All the rest of him was in the tunnel. Albert began to dig with his feet, and we stood on the ground over him, waiting. So he dig with his boots, only his face is visible. Everyone is waiting for treasure. Now, on next day, we will read the rest of the part of this story. So, the classwork is to write the summary which I have explained in this video. Till then, have a nice day.